Welcome to my video tutorial on gross anatomy of lateral wall of nose. At the end of this video, you should be able to know bones forming the lateral wall of nose, its bony framework, relations, epithelial lining, openings into its meatuses, blood supply, nerve supply, lymphatic drainage, and few applied aspects. So let's begin. Before we begin, let's get oriented about nasal cavity. Here is the coronal section of head showing the nasal cavity, which is divided into two asymmetrical halves by nasal septum. Each half of the nasal cavity is bounded by medial wall, lateral wall, roof, and floor. Medial wall is nothing but nasal septum. Roof is related with anterior cranial fossa. Floor is formed by hard palate, which separates the nasal cavity from oral cavity below. Lateral wall of the nose is related with paranasal air sinuses and bony orbit with its contents. Let's know about the lateral wall of nose in detail. Bones forming the lateral wall of nose. From anterior to posterior, they are nasal bone, frontal process of maxilla, lacrimal bone. Behind the lacrimal bone, there are three bony shelf-like projections which project into the nasal cavity. They are called as conchae or turbinates. From above downwards, they are superior concha, middle concha, and inferior concha. Superior and middle conchae, they are projections from labyrinth of ethmoid bone, whereas inferior concha is a separate bone. Behind the conchae, there lies perpendicular plate of palatine bone. More posteriorly, medial pterygoid plate of sphenoid bone forms the bony framework. Each concha encloses a narrow space deep to it, which is known as meatus. As there are three conchae, there are three meatuses enclosed by respective concha. They are superior meatus, middle meatus, and inferior meatus. Let's understand these conchae and their meatuses in this following video clip. Here is the nasal septum seen through the anterior nasal aperture. Let's see the nasal cavity by taking a coronal section. Here is the nasal cavity, which is divided by nasal septum into two halves. Below it is related with hard palate, above by anterior cranial fossa, and bilaterally bony orbits and paranasal air sinuses. Each half of the nasal cavity medially related with nasal septum. Here is the lateral wall of nasal cavity, which shows three shelf-like bony projections. They are called as conchae or turbinates. Here is the inferior concha, middle concha, and here is the superior concha. They enclose spaces deep to them called as meatuses. Here is the inferior meatus, middle meatus, and here is the superior meatus. Let's quickly revise the bones forming the lateral wall of nose. From anterior to posterior, they are nasal bone, frontal process of maxilla, lacrimal bone. Behind the lacrimal bone, there are three conchae or turbinates, superior concha, middle concha, and inferior concha. Posteriorly, there lies perpendicular plate of palatine bone and medial pterygoid plate of sphenoid bone. More anteriorly, towards the tip of the nose, lateral wall is also supported by few cartilages. They are lateral nasal cartilage and alar cartilages. Relations of lateral wall of the nose. Above it is related with orbital plate of frontal bone, which separates the nasal cavity from anterior cranial fossa above. Below it is related with hard palate, which separates the nasal cavity from oral cavity below. Anteriorly it is related with nasal bone, nasal cartilage, and alar cartilage. Posteriorly it is related with body of sphenoid bone. If we observe the conchae or turbinates of lateral wall, inferior concha is the largest one, whereas superior concha is smallest one. Each concha shows lower free border. Lower border of the inferior concha extends horizontally. Posteriorly, it lies 1.25 cm in front of pharyngeal opening of auditory tube or Eustachian tube. Anteriorly, it is continuous with a mucocutaneous ridge known as limen nasi. Lower border of middle concha extends horizontally. Anteriorly, it shows a vertical limb, which is continuous with an ill-defined mucous ridge anteriorly known as agar nasi. Posteriorly, it lies at the level of inferior surface of body of sphenoid bone. Superior concha is related with a narrow space or depression posteriorly known as sphenoethmoidal recess, which lies in front of body of sphenoid bone. The part of nasal cavity lying below the limen nasi is known as vestibule, which is slightly dilated part of nasal cavity seen within the alae above the nostrils. Part of nasal cavity seen between agar nasi and limen nasi is known as atrium. The lateral wall is lined by mucous membrane except vestibule, where it is lined by skin and its appendages. Here is the vestibule, which is lined by skin, whereas the rest of the lateral wall lined by mucous membrane, which is richly supplied by blood vessels and nasal glands. Epithelial lining of lateral wall of the nose. Functionally, lateral wall can be divided into three regions, which are lined by three different epithelia. They are anteriorly vestibule, near the roof of nasal cavity, olfactory region. Rest of the lateral wall is known as respiratory region. Vestibule is lined by skin, having stratified squamous keratinized epithelium, coarse hair, sebaceous and sweat glands. Here the coarse hair helps in filtering the foreign particles. Olfactory region is lined by olfactory epithelium, having bipolar olfactory cells, tall columnar cells and basal cells. Respiratory region is lined by pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium, having mucus and serous glands, which helps in trapping the inhaled particles and microorganisms. Such trapped material move backwards by the movements of cilia towards nasopharynx, from where they are ejected by sneezing or coughing reflex through ciliary rejection current, which is a natural defense mechanism. So there are three different epithelia which line the lateral wall of the nose. Coming to the meatuses and their openings into the lateral wall of nose. As we have seen, there are three meatuses enclosed deep to the three conchae. Deep to the superior concha, there lies superior meatus. Deep to middle concha, middle meatus. And deep to inferior concha, there lies inferior meatus. These three meatuses posteriorly continuous with nasopharynx through posterior nasal aperture or choana. Anteriorly, inferior meatus continuous with vestibule, middle meatus continuous with atrium of nasal cavity. The area between superior concha and roof of nasal cavity is known as supreme meatus. Occasionally, it may be traversed by highest concha. Such meatuses receive openings of paranasal air sinuses. Let's see the further details of these openings. Openings seen in the meatuses of lateral wall of the nose belong to paranasal air sinuses, which open through their ostia into different meatuses. Basically, to enclose such narrow ostia, conchae are developed and meatuses are formed. Let's briefly know about paranasal air sinuses. They are seen around the nasal cavity, within the pneumatic bones, lined by mucous membrane. Depending on the bone in which they lie, they are four types: frontal, maxillary, ethmoidal and sphenoidal air sinuses. All are paired sinuses. Let's locate these sinuses. Frontal air sinuses lie within the frontal bones. Maxillary air sinuses lie within the body of maxillae, their largest air sinuses. Ethmoidal air sinuses lie within the labyrinth of ethmoid bone. They are small air sinuses grouped into anterior, middle and posterior ethmoidal air sinuses. Sphenoidal air sinuses are seen within the body of sphenoid bone. It lies more posteriorly, can be seen only in the sagittal plane. Now it's time to see which meatus is receiving which air sinus opening into it. Opening into the inferior meatus. It is the only meatus which does not receive the opening of paranasal air sinus. It receives opening of nasolacrimal duct, which is the output of lacrimal apparatus. Let's locate this opening in sagittal section. Here is the section of inferior concha, here is the inferior meatus, and here is the opening of nasolacrimal duct, which is the only opening seen in inferior meatus. Openings into the middle meatus. Here is the section of inferior concha and here is the middle concha. Here is the middle meatus, which shows a bony bulging below the middle concha known as bulla ethmoidalis. Below the bulla, it shows a crescentic depression known as hiatus semilunaris. The anterior or upper end of hiatus extends upwards and forwards in the form of a mucous diverticulum known as ethmoidal infundibulum. So the features seen within the middle meatus are a bony bulging called as bulla ethmoidalis, below that a crescentic depression known as hiatus semilunaris, which upwards extends as ethmoidal infundibulum. Let's see which air sinuses open into these features. Here is the sagittal section of bulla ethmoidalis. Here is the hiatus semilunaris and here is the ethmoidal infundibulum, which receives opening of frontal air sinus from its summit directly or through frontonasal duct. Its wall receives the openings of anterior group of ethmoidal air sinuses, whereas the floor of hiatus semilunaris receives the opening or ostium of maxillary air sinus, which lies just below the bulla ethmoidalis. Within the bulla, middle group of ethmoidal air sinuses lie, which open onto the surface of bulla ethmoidalis. Basically, the air sinuses which open into middle meatus are frontal, maxillary, anterior and middle group of ethmoidal air sinuses. Superior meatus receives openings of posterior group of ethmoidal air sinuses. Here they are. The space seen in front of the body of sphenoid bone known as sphenoethmoidal recess, which receives the opening of sphenoidal air sinus. Here it is. Let's quickly revise the meatuses and their openings. Inferior meatus receives the opening of nasolacrimal duct. Middle meatus receives the openings of frontal air sinus, anterior group of ethmoidal air sinuses through ethmoidal infundibulum, maxillary air sinus into the floor of hiatus semilunaris, whereas middle group of ethmoidal air sinuses on the surface of bulla ethmoidalis. Superior meatus receives the openings of posterior group of ethmoidal air sinuses. Sphenoidal air sinus opens into sphenoethmoidal recess. The points to be understood here are: inferior meatus does not receive openings of air sinuses. Middle meatus is largest space, receives more number of ear sinuses, frontal, maxillary, anterior and middle ethmoidal ear sinuses. The only ear sinus does not open into any meatus is sphenoidal ear sinus, which opens into sphenoethmoidal recess. Moving on to the blood supply. Arterial supply of lateral wall of the nose. Based on the distribution of arteries, lateral wall of the nose can be divided into four quadrants: anterosuperior, anteroinferior, posterosuperior and posteroinferior quadrants. Anterosuperior quadrant is supplied by anterior ethmoidal artery through its lateral nasal branches. Anteroinferior quadrant is supplied by facial artery through its alar branches and greater palatine artery through its terminal branches. Posteroposterior quadrant is supplied by branches from sphenopalatine artery, whereas posteroinferior quadrant is usually supplied by branches from greater palatine artery, or it may be supplied by branches from sphenopalatine artery. Anterior ethmoidal artery is a branch of ophthalmic artery, which in turn is a branch of internal carotid artery. Facial artery is a branch of external carotid artery. Greater palatine and sphenopalatine arteries are branches of maxillary artery, which in turn is a branch of external carotid artery. Basically, lateral wall of the nose is supplied by branches from external carotid artery and internal carotid artery, which anastomose on the lateral wall of the nose. Coming to the venous drainage of lateral wall of the nose. Veins form plexus on the lateral wall. Veins arising from the plexus drain in three directions. In front, they drain into facial vein. Behind, they drain into retropharyngeal vein and pterygoid venous plexus. Above, they drain into inferior cerebral veins. Let's move on to nerve supply of lateral wall of the nose. Mucous membrane lining the lateral wall receives sensory, secretomotor and vasomotor nerve fibers. Let's see the details of these innervations. Sensory fibers, which carry special and general sensations from lateral wall of the nose. Special sensory fibers are derived from olfactory nerves, which are seen in the upper part of lateral wall of the nose. Rest of the lateral wall is supplied by general sensory fibers. Depending on their distribution, lateral wall can be divided into four quadrants, similar to its arterial supply. Anterosuperior quadrant is supplied by anterior ethmoidal nerve, which is a branch of ophthalmic nerve. Anteroinferior quadrant is supplied by anterior superior alveolar nerve, which is a branch of maxillary nerve. Posteroposterior quadrant is supplied by posteroposterior lateral nasal branch from pterygopalatine ganglion. Posteroinferior quadrant is supplied by posteroinferior lateral nasal branch, which is a branch of greater palatine nerve, which in turn is a branch of pterygopalatine ganglion. Basically, anterior half of the lateral wall is supplied by cranial nerve, that is trigeminal nerve, through its divisions ophthalmic and maxillary nerves. Posterior half of the lateral wall is supplied by autonomic nerves through pterygopalatine ganglion. Secretomotor fibers. They belong to parasympathetic system. Preganglionic parasympathetic fibers arise from superior salivatory nucleus. From there, they pass through the facial nerve, greater petrosal nerve, which unites with the deep petrosal nerve to form nerve of pterygoid canal, which pass through the pterygoid canal and relay in pterygopalatine ganglion. From there, postganglionic parasympathetic fibers arise in the form of posterolateral nasal branches, which supply nasal mucosal glands. Vasomotor fibers. They belong to sympathetic system and they supply vessels supplying the nasal glands. Preganglionic sympathetic fibers arise from upper 3 or 4 thoracic spinal cord segments. From there, They pass through the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion, where they relay, and postganglionic sympathetic fibers arise, which form plexus around internal carotid artery. From the plexus, deep petrosal nerve arise, which pass through the pterygoid canal along with greater petrosal nerve to form nerve of pterygoid canal. Fibers from deep petrosal nerve do not relay in pterygopalatine ganglion. They enter into posterior lateral nasal branches and supply the vessels in the mucosa. So the mucosa of lateral wall of the nose is innervated by sensory, secretomotor and vasomotor fibers. Special sensory fibers carry sense of smell through olfactory nose in the upper part. General sensory fibers carry pain, touch, temperature through the branches of ophthalmic and maxillary nerves in the anterior part and through the branches of pterygopalatine ganglion in the posterior part. Secretomotor fibers belong to parasympathetic system. They supply the nasal mucosal glands. Vasomotor fibers belong to sympathetic system. They supply vessels supplying the mucosal glands. Moving on to lymphatic drainage of lateral wall of the nose. From the anterior half of lateral wall of the nose, lymph channels drain into submandibular lymph nodes. From posterior half of lateral wall, lymphatics drain into retropharyngeal lymph nodes and deep cervical lymph nodes. Efferents from these lymph nodes form jugular lymph trunk, which run on the internal jugular vein, opens into thoracic duct on the left side and right lymphatic duct on right side. Basically, lymph from the lateral wall of nose drains into two directions, anteriorly into submandibular lymph nodes and posteriorly into retropharyngeal and deep cervical lymph nodes. Now it's time to see the applied aspects. Sinusitis, inflammation of mucous membrane lining the paranasal air sinuses, which leads to accumulation of infected material within the sinus. Maxillary sinusitis is being most commonest one. It can be treated through natural drainage or through antral lavage or antral wash, where a catheter is passed through the nostrils into the meatus, where the ostium of paranasal air sinus is opening, so that the pus collected within the sinus can be drained through the catheter. Nasal polyps. They are fleshy benign outgrowths from mucous membrane of lateral wall of the nose. They are secondary to chronic inflammation of the mucous membrane or due to chronic sinusitis. Polyps developing due to maxillary sinusitis are seen projecting through the middle meatus, hang over the inferior concha. They cause nasal obstruction and may bleed through the nose. Injury to olfactory nerves leads to loss of sense of smell called as anosmia. It is due to trauma where the fracture of cribriform plate is seen near the roof of nasal cavity, which may lead to leakage of CSF through the nasal cavity known as CSF rhinorrhea. Deviation of nasal septum, which leads to unilateral nasal obstruction by compressing on nasal conchae and blocking the openings of paranasal air sinuses. Here is the end of this video with gross anatomy of lateral wall of nose in detail. Thank you for your patient listening. Keep learning.